Dear listeners, tonight I will take you on a journey into the shadowy depths of the desert, where an ancient and terrifying legend comes to life. The curse of the Egyptian god Anubis. Picture the vast, scorching sands stretching out endlessly beneath a merciless sun. And at its heart, a hidden temple waiting to reveal its dark secrets. Settle in comfortably, close your eyes, and let yourselves be enveloped by this tale of courage, mystery, and the relentless pursuit of truth. Shadows of Anubis face the curse of Egyptian god. Under the scorching sun of the vast desert, a group of courageous explorers embarked on a journey that would change their lives forever. Led by the renowned archaeologist Dr. Elena Radcliffe, they were a team driven by an unquenchable thirst for knowledge and the promise of uncovering the mysteries of the ancient world. Their destination, a temple dedicated to the Egyptian god Anubis, long lost to the sands of time. The entrance to this forgotten sanctuary had been hidden for millennia beneath the shifting sands, waiting for the day it would be revealed once more. The team had spent months deciphering ancient maps and inscriptions, their excitement growing with each clue that brought them closer to their goal. And now, standing before the ancient stone doorway, their hearts pounded with anticipation. The desert heat bore down on them, but it was the thrill of discovery that truly set their blood racing. As they carefully cleared away the last of the sand and debris, the entrance loomed before them, dark and foreboding. The carvings on the stone, though worn by the ages, still held an aura of reverence and mystery. They depicted scenes of Anubis, the jackal-headed god of the afterlife, guiding souls through the underworld. Each figure seemed to watch them, eyes following their every movement, as if judging their worthiness to enter this sacred space. With a deep breath, Dr. Radcliffe led her team into the temple's shadowy depths. The air inside was cool and stale, a stark contrast to the blazing desert outside. Each step they took echoed through the stone corridors, the sound amplifying the sense of solitude and isolation. They moved slowly, methodically, their flashlights casting eerie shadows on the walls. Only the gentle ruffle of sand and the sporadic drop of water broke the deafening calm as they descended farther. They could feel history bearing down on them more and more as they descended. The temple's walls seemed to be whispering tales about a bygone era, when it was a center of power and worship. Then, the phenomena began. At first, it was subtle, a flicker of movement at the edge of their vision, a shadow that seemed to shift when no one was looking directly at it. They dismissed it as a trick of the light, a product of their tired minds and the dim illumination of their flashlights. But as they continued, the occurrences grew more frequent and harder to ignore. Shadows danced along the walls, moving with a life of their own. They twisted and writhed, forming shapes that were almost human, almost familiar. Dr. Radcliffe felt a chill run down her spine as she watched one particularly dark shadow stretch out a hand, as if reaching for something just out of reach. She blinked, and it was gone. Whispers began to fill the air, soft and indistinct at first, but growing clearer with each passing moment. They spoke in ancient tongues, voices from the past that seemed to plead and warn. The team exchanged uneasy glances, each member feeling the same creeping dread. The whispers grew louder, forming words that none of them understood. Yet the meaning was clear. They were not alone. Then came the apparitions. Ghostly figures of ancient priests, their forms translucent and ethereal, began to appear. They moved with purpose, their eyes glowing with an unearthly light. These spectral guardians seemed to be reliving moments from their lives, performing rituals and prayers to Anubis. The explorers watched in awe and fear, unsure whether these spirits were there to guide them or to ward them off. Dr. Radcliffe stood transfixed as one of the priests turned to face her, his eyes meeting hers with a gaze that pierced through to her very soul. She felt a connection, a bridge across time, and for a moment, she understood the weight of their journey. This was not just an archaeological expedition. It was a communion with the past, a chance to uncover truths that had been buried for thousands of years. The atmosphere grew tense with each passing moment. The explorers moved forward, driven by a mix of curiosity and fear. The shadows, whispers, and apparitions seemed to be leading them deeper into the labyrinth, drawing them towards something that lay hidden in the heart of the temple. The air grew thicker, the sense of anticipation mounting with every step. Dr. Radcliffe could feel the unease growing among her team. They were seasoned explorers, each one a veteran of many such expeditions. But this was different. There was a presence here, a force that watched and waited. They could all sense it, a looming shadow that seemed to pulse with a life of its own. They pressed on, driven by the promise of history unveiled, yet wary of the ancient darkness that surrounded them. The temple, once a place of worship and reverence, had become a place of shadows and secrets. And as they ventured further into its depths, they realized that they were on the brink of a discovery that would challenge everything they knew about the ancient world and the mysteries it held. In the heart of the desert, under the watchful gaze of Anubis, the explorers were about to uncover the secrets of the past. But what they did not yet know was that the shadows held more than just memories. They held the key to a power that had been waiting to be unleashed for millennia. And as they continued their descent into the darkness, they could only hope that they would emerge unscathed on the other side. Mark was one of the brave adventurers who braved the ancient temple. He was a seasoned traveler with an unquenchable curiosity and an eye for detail. Mark was well known for his attention to detail and keen intuition, and he had a talent for finding secret information in the most improbable places. This exact ability allowed him to make a startling discovery that would drastically alter the path of their journey, deep in the temple's gloomy passageways. As the team carefully navigated the labyrinthine passages, Mark found himself drawn to a small, dimly lit alcove. Something about it called to him. A faint whisper in the back of his mind, urging him to explore further. With deliberate steps, he approached the alcove, his flashlight casting long, eerie shadows on the ancient stone walls. There, nestled in the dust and debris of centuries, he spotted something remarkable. An ancient manuscript. The manuscript was fragile, its pages brittle with age, whispering secrets of the past as he gently handled them. The cover was adorned with intricate hieroglyphics and symbols that spoke of a time long forgotten. Mark's heart raced with excitement as he carefully opened it, revealing the delicate, yellowed pages within. Each page was filled with beautifully crafted script, a testament to the skill and reverence of its creators. A shiver went down Mark's spine as he started to decipher the old writing. The document described the heart of Anubis, a mysterious relic endowed with the ability to regulate life and death. The document said that the artifact was concealed by strong curses and antiquated magic deep within the temple. This item was claimed to possess the potential to bend reality itself, a capability that might either rescue or destroy anyone who sought it. The more Mark read, the heavier the weight of dread that settled over him. The manuscript revealed that the temple was cursed, a malevolent force that had lain dormant for millennia. This curse, it explained, could only be lifted by finding and destroying the heart of Anubis. Failure to do so would result in dire consequences, a fate worse than death for those who dared to disturb the temple's sanctity. As Mark shared his findings with the rest of the team, a palpable sense of fear began to take hold. The weight of the revelation hung heavy in the air, each member of the team processing the enormity of what they had uncovered. The once exhilarating promise of discovery now carried with it a dark and foreboding shadow. They realized that they were not just exploring an ancient temple. They were entwined in a struggle against forces beyond their understanding. Tensions began to flare as the team pressed on, each step deeper into the temple, feeling like a step closer to an uncertain doom. The knowledge of the curse weighed heavily on their minds, amplifying the sense of unease that had been building since they first entered the temple. Whispers of fear and doubt began to circulate, eroding the camaraderie and trust that had once bound them together. Mark could see the strain in their faces, the fear that flickered in their eyes. Each member of the team was grappling with their own demons, the knowledge of the curse gnawing at their resolve. As they ventured further, the temple seemed to come alive with malevolent energy, the shadows growing darker and more oppressive. The whispers grew louder, more insistent, echoing off the stone walls and filling their minds with dread. It wasn't long before the curse began to claim its first victims. One by one, members of the team fell prey to the malevolent force that permeated the temple. Their bodies would convulse and writhe as if possessed by an unseen entity, their screams echoing through the dark corridors. And then, in a horrifying transformation, their physical forms would dissolve into shadows, merging with the darkness that surrounded them, These shadows, once human, now moved with a sinister purpose, their eyes glowing with an eerie light. They seemed to be under the control of Anubis, the ancient god watching over his domain. The loss of their comrades was a heavy blow, each transformation a grim reminder of the curse's power and the urgency of their quest. The remaining members of the team grew more desperate, their fear fueling their determination to find and destroy the heart of Anubis. Even though Mark felt guilty and sad for his buddies who had died, he knew they had to keep on. A ray of hope had appeared in the form of the manuscript, offering them a means of breaking the curse and avoiding the same destiny. However, the route ahead was treacherous, with each step bringing them nearer to the temple center and the relic that either held the key to their redemption or their destruction. As the team moved forward, the atmosphere grew ever more oppressive. The shadows seemed to close in around them, the whispers growing louder and more urgent. Every corner held the potential for new horrors, every step echoing with the fear of the unknown. Yet, driven by the knowledge of what was at stake, they continued their perilous journey into the depths of the temple. Mark clutched the ancient manuscript tightly, its fragile pages a constant reminder of the curse they faced and the task that lay ahead. With each step, he felt the weight of their mission pressing down on him, the lives of his comrades, and the fate of their expedition resting on his shoulders. The heart of Anubis awaited them in the darkness, a beacon of hope and danger in equal measure. And as they ventured deeper into the shadowy labyrinth, they could only hope that their courage and determination would be enough to see them through the trials that lay ahead. With their numbers dwindling and the shadows closing in, Dr. Elena Radcliffe and the few remaining members of her team knew they were in a desperate race against time. The ancient temple, with its hidden corridors and malevolent presence, was not just a place of discovery anymore. It was a labyrinth of danger and despair. They had to find the heart of Anubis, the mystical artifact that held the key to lifting the curse, and they had to find it quickly. The ghostly priest, an ethereal guardian bound to the temple, emerged from the shadows to offer cryptic guidance. His form was translucent, flickering in the dim light of their flashlights. His eyes, glowing with an otherworldly light, held a mixture of sorrow and urgency. He spoke in riddles, his voice a soft whisper that seemed to echo from the very walls of the temple. Each clue he provided was a puzzle, a test of their resolve and intellect. "Seek the chamber where the light does not touch," the priest intoned, his voice like a breeze rustling through ancient leaves. "There, beneath the gaze of Anubis, lies the heart that beats with life and death." Dr. Radcliffe listened intently, her mind racing to piece together the meaning behind his words. She could feel the weight of her responsibility pressing down on her, the lives of her remaining team members, and the souls of those lost depending on her. She could not afford to falter, not now when they were so close. Guided by the priest's cryptic clues, they navigated through the temple's treacherous passages. Each step they took was fraught walls seemingly closing in around them, the air growing heavier with each breath. They encountered deadly traps, remnants of an age when the temple had been a place of sacred rites and powerful magic. Ancient mechanisms, long dormant, sprang to life as they passed, spewing darts and igniting flames in a final, desperate bid to protect the secrets within. Despite the increasing danger, Dr. Radcliffe's determination never wavered. Her heart pounded with fear, but it also surged with resolve. She led her team with unwavering focus, her keen intellect deciphering the priest's riddles and guiding them through the maze of death traps and hidden passages. Each clue, each step, brought them closer to the final chamber, but also closer to their own doom. The spectral priest appeared again, his presence a mix of comfort and foreboding. "The path to the heart is lined with the souls of the damned," he whispered, his voice a mournful dirge. "Tread carefully, for they guard the way with their eternal vigilance." The team moved cautiously, their flashlights cutting through the thick darkness. Shadows danced on the walls, and the air was thick with the weight of ancient sorrows. They could feel the eyes of the damned upon them, restless spirits bound to the temple by the curse. The air grew colder, the oppressive silence broken only by the faint rustle of unseen movements and the distant echoes of their own footsteps. As they pressed on, the clues became more obscure, the path more perilous. They encountered murals and carvings that depicted scenes of judgment and retribution, the imagery both beautiful and terrifying. Each image seemed to pulse with a life of its own, the eyes of Anubis watching their every move. The sense of being watched, judged, and tested grew stronger with each passing moment. Dr. Radcliffe led her team through a narrow corridor, the walls closing in until they were forced to move single file. The air was thick with the scent of ancient dust and the faint tang of fear. Ahead of them, a faint glow illuminated the end of the corridor, a doorway framed by the intricate carvings of Anubis and his jackal-headed minions. "This must be it," she whispered, her voice barely audible above the thundering of her heart. "The final chamber." The spectral priest appeared once more, his form wavering like a candle flame in the darkness. "Beyond this door lies the heart," he said, his voice heavy with the weight of centuries. "But beware, for the guardians will not let it go easily. Only the pure of heart, the brave of spirit, will succeed." With a deep breath, Dr. Radcliffe pushed open the door. In the heart of the ancient temple, the air was thick with tension and the weight of ages past. Dr. Elena Radcliffe and her remaining team members stood at the threshold of the secret chamber, their faces illuminated by the eerie glow emanating from within. The heart of Anubis, a crystalline artifact pulsating with dark energy, lay at the center of the room, casting long shadows that danced along the stone walls. As they stepped into the chamber, a palpable sense of foreboding enveloped them. The air seemed to hum with an unearthly energy, the vibrations resonating through their very bones. Each step they took was measured and cautious, their eyes fixed on the glowing crystal that held the key to their salvation. the shadows in the room began to close in, swirling around them like dark phantoms. Their presence, an ominous reminder of the power they were about to confront. Dr. Radcliffe's heart pounded in her chest as she approached the heart of Anubis. The artifact seemed to pulse in response, its dark energy growing more intense with each passing moment. She could feel the weight of the ancient curse pressing down on her, the souls trapped within the crystal, crying out for release. Her determination to end their suffering and lift the curse drove her forward, despite the overwhelming fear that gnawed at the edges of her resolve. The temple began to quake, the very foundations trembling as if in protest of their intrusion. Stones shifted and dust fell from the ceiling, the ancient structure groaning under the strain. The team exchanged anxious glances, their breaths quickening as the intensity of the situation escalated. The shadows grew darker and more oppressive, their forms twisting and writhing as they closed in around the explorers. In a climactic moment of bravery, Dr. Radcliffe reached out and grasped the heart of Anubis. The instant her fingers made contact with the crystal, a surge of dark energy coursed through her, filling her with a chilling cold. She could feel the ancient power of the artifact, a force that had been waiting millennia to be unleashed. Summoning all her strength and determination, she lifted the crystal high above her head, ready to end the curse once and for all. With a primal scream that echoed through the chamber, Dr. Radcliffe brought the crystal crashing down onto the stone altar. The heart of Anubis shattered into 1,000 pieces, each shard pulsating briefly before fading into nothingness. A blinding flash of light filled the room, and the shadows let out a collective wail as they began to dissipate, their dark forms dissolving into the air. The temple's trembling grew more violent, the ancient stones cracking and shifting as the structure began to collapse around them. Dr. Radcliffe and her team scrambled to escape, navigating the crumbling passageways with a desperate urgency. The ground beneath them shook, and debris rained down from above. The once majestic temple, now a chaotic ruin. They pushed forward, their breaths ragged and their bodies aching, driven by the primal instinct to survive. As they burst through the temple's entrance and into the blinding sunlight, a sense of profound relief washed over them. They stumbled into the open desert, collapsing onto the warm sand as the temple behind them continued to fall into ruin. The oppressive weight of the curse lifted, and the air seemed clear, the whispers and shadows that had haunted them finally gone. Dr. Radcliffe lay on the sand, her chest heaving with exhaustion, her mind reeling from the intensity of their ordeal. She had lost friends, comrades who had ventured into the depths with her and paid the ultimate price. The pain of those losses marked her, a heavy burden that she would carry with her always. But alongside that, pain was a sense of triumph, a deep satisfaction that they had succeeded in their mission. As she gazed at the ruins of the temple, now bathed in the golden light of the setting sun, Dr. Radcliffe felt a newfound understanding of the past and the mystical forces that had shaped it. The curse of Anubis was finally broken, the trapped souls released from their millennia-long torment. The ancient secrets they had uncovered would not be forgotten, but would serve as a testament to the bravery and determination of her team. The surviving members of the expedition gathered around her, their faces etched with a mixture of relief and sorrow. They had endured so much, faced unimaginable horrors, and emerged victorious. With the curse lifted, they felt a renewed sense of purpose and resolve. They vowed to continue their explorations, to seek out the mysteries of the past with the same courage and tenacity that had brought them through this harrowing ordeal. Dr. Radcliffe stood, her gaze fixed on the horizon, the sun casting long shadows behind her. She knew that their journey was far from over, that there were still countless wonders and dangers awaiting them in the world. But for now, they had triumphed over the darkness, and the light of their success would guide them forward. After taking one last long glance at the temple's remnants, Dr. Radcliffe faced her group. Buoyed by the knowledge that they had battled Anubis's shadows and prevailed over them, they set forth across the desert together. Ahead of them lay an infinite future full with opportunities and the prospect of exciting new experiences. And as they strolled, the sun disappeared beyond the horizon, revealing a sky filled with hues, symbolic of rebirth and optimism. And so, my dear listeners, that was Shadows of Anubis. Dr. Elena Radcliffe and her courageous team uncovered the ancient mysteries and lifted the curse that had plagued the temple for millennia. Their bravery and determination shone through the darkest depths of the temple, bringing light and hope where there was once only shadow and despair. Remember, behind every shadow lies a story waiting to be told, and within every ancient relic, a truth yearning to be discovered. If you enjoyed tonight's journey into the heart of the desert and the secrets it held, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you never miss another tale of mystery and adventure. What would you have done in Dr. Radcliffe's place? Would you have dared to venture into the depths of the unknown to lift an ancient curse? Let us know in the comments below. Until next time, may you have sweet dreams and magical adventures in every night.